It looks like California isn't the only state that's in trouble. We have 19 states that need to pass a budget within days, or they're going to have a hard time paying their bills. The Democrats' environmental bill is being rushed through the House by Nancy Pelosi, and it looks like it's going to be one of the biggest taxes we've ever seen. June 25th, 2009. I'm Reginald, also known as DemCAD. First, California is going to issue some IOUs in about a week. If they can't resolve a $24 billion budget deficit, they're going to start issuing some IOUs. Basically, they don't have any money, simply put. They shot down some measures to cut taxes a while ago. You know, Arnold Schwarzenegger had some measures to cut down welfare and some other entitlement programs and services, but that was shot down. I don't know how they're going to fill this gap. I don't know what's going to happen. I mean, I think it's going to basically be bankrupt, but it looks like, well, the controller of California said, I quote, "Next Wednesday, we will start a financial year with a massively underbalanced spending plan and a cash shortfall not seen since the Great Depression." Wow. Yeah. California is the only state that's really struggling. We have 19 states that need to approve a 2010 budget before next Tuesday. And it looks like a lot of services are going to get shut down if they don't pass these budgets. Basically, what happens when they don't pass a budget, they start shutting services down, agencies down. Some states they have provisions for certain services to continue whether they have a budget or not. But in a lot of states, they're going to start issuing IOUs just like California. And what they can do is pass some temporary provisions, bills that basically say, okay, we're going to pay the light bill and whatever, though, the basic bills for a while, but cap and tax friction. Basically, Nancy Pelosi is rushing this environmental bill, this cap and trade legislation through the House. According to the CBO, the Congressional Budget Office, the climate legislation will only cost the average household $175 a year. Although $175 a year is a lot of money to pay for something you're not necessarily in support of. Under the cap and trade, the government is going to try to limit carbon emissions by basically forcing companies to buy and sell permits for carbon, CO2, to actually emit CO2. So they're going to put a national cap on what the whole country can emit. And if you want a permit, you're going to have to pay, basically. An idea is to sort of give companies incentive not to emit too much CO2. But the problem is we're a carbon-based life form, and the economy sort of involves a lot of emitting of CO2. So I don't know how you can really pass this without killing the economy. It's going down anyway, so why not, I guess. GM to cut 4,000 more white-collar workers. Yeah, or should I say jobs? I like how I say they're going to cut. I guess that would make more sense. They're going to cut the jobs, not the workers, but yeah, it seems more impersonal when you say the jobs are gone. But anyway, a lot of them will get severance packages. A lot of them will go into early retirement. So at least they have something. Harvard is cutting 275 jobs. Their endowment is down significantly. I think we're going to see universities all across this country really shut down because, I mean, we have so many, and a lot of those degrees are just crap. I mean, I'm not going to go into all that. Anyway, Chicago violence endangers vital blood supply. Dr. Dennis said, "We probably see an average of between 10 and 15 people who get shot or stabbed every night. This is one doctor at one hospital." I wonder what's going to happen when things really go south. Pentagon approves creation of Cyber Command. The Cyber Command chief is going to be running the NSA, and it's going to bring together all of the Pentagon's cyber efforts. And the system is going to be run by a computer named HAL. I'm kidding. Okay, the number of the world's millionaires is shrinking. Wow, big surprise there. I mean, durable good orders are actually rising. They unexpectedly rose in May. So the big ticket manufacturing goods rose sharply for the second straight month in May. So there's some good news right there for you. So it rose higher than they even expected it to. They expected it to decline by 0.6. It rose by 1.8%. So there's your good news for today. Program pays girls $1 per day to not get pregnant. No, I'm not making this story up. $1 a day if you're between 12 and 18 to not get pregnant. Okay. Here's an idea for a program. For every day that I don't rob a liquor store, you guys are going to give me $1. Oh, man. I would like to issue a special thank you to everybody who watched my blog TV last Sunday, especially to Bill Lynch Can. This guy came on the video. He's from Canada, I think Ontario, and I spoke with him. Pretty cool guy. Man, I wish we didn't have such a long delay. You know? It's like a 4-second delay or something. But anyway, Bill Lynch Can, thank you. And I'm going to be doing a blog TV 7 p.m. on Thursday, which is today, hopefully, at 7 p.m. Pacific time. I'm not going by Alaska time, I'm going by Pacific time. So 7 p.m. Pacific time. And I'll post a video with a link, and I'll have a link to that channel in this video, in my description box, but I'll make another video. So you're just basically clicking on the link, and it's just like this video, except it'll be live, and you can chat. But you have to register if you want to actually type in something. So hope to see you guys there. Bye.